अस्मान् विश्वानि देवो वायुना विद्वान् यो धस्मत् जुरा मेनो भूयिष्ठां ते नम उक्तिं विधेम ॐ अग्नये नमः आवाहयामि स्थापयामि ध्यायामि ततो नमस्कारं करोमि। आप ले लीजिए। Everybody knows the picture. Can someone tell who is it? Swami Vivekananda.
Very good.
Excellent.
Four.
Okay. So, who was he? Guru? Yes, he was a master. And he came to Chicago to address World Parliament of Religions in 1893. And then he established Ramakrishna Mission. And Swamiji is from Ramakrishna Mission, Baroda head office. He's the head of the Baroda office, Baroda Center. So I will ask Dilip Bhai to honor with the flowers. To Swamiji. Another round of applause. We will ask Suchita Ben to honor Arunima Singh. Arunima Singh. Arunima Singh. Ranjan Bengalji Dupatta on the behalf of Gayatri Gyan Kendra of Long Island. Sadra Ben, Sarada Ben will give the flower. One big round of applause. Bring the instrument to play Swamiji here. And I will ask Suchita Ben to give the dupatta of.
Om Prakash.
Yeah, Om Prakash here. I will ask Punima Ben to introduce Swamiji. I have already sent you the information, but Punima Ben will introduce Swamiji. And then Swamiji will introduce Arunima Singh.
Namaste, good morning. Respected Swami Nikhileshwarananji, respected Bhadra Ben Shah, Arunima Ji, and Om Prakash Ji. and all our parents and students of Gayatri Gnan Kendra. It is a great honor to introduce Swamiji. Swami Nikhileshwaranji is the head of Baroda Center of the Ramakrishna Mission. This mission was started by Swami Vivekananda more than 100 years ago, and it has headquartered situated at Belur Math near Kolkata. Swamiji graduated in 1970 with honors as a chemical engineer and later postgraduated in 1972. He worked as a management consultant for a few years. He renounced the world and joined Ramakrishna Mission at Belur Math. The name Swami Nikhileshwaranand was given to him by his guru, Swami Vireshwaranandji Maharaj, at the time of his sannyas. Swamiji has visited many countries such as USA, UK, South Africa, Mauritius, Germany, France, Netherlands, Switzerland, and many more. He has toured extensively preaching the message of Vedanta in various industrial, management, and educational institutions. He has also participated in many interfaith conferences, which have been greatly appreciated. We are so much fortunate to have Swamiji here today to address our students and parents and to bless us with his divine knowledge. Thank you. I would like to thank you.
Asato ma sadgamaya, tamaso ma jyotirgamaya, mrityor ma mritam gamaya. Om shantihi, shantihi, shantihi. Dear Sri Pravin Bhai Kapadia and family members, and all the volunteers and the organizers of this wonderful Gayatri Gyan Kendra of Long Island, the parents present here, my dear young children, Dr. Bhadra Ben Shah, who has been instrumental in organizing all these programs for me in New York and New Jersey area in during my this third visit to USA, Sri Om Prakash Ji, and the person who is now a celebrity not only of India but all over the world, that is Arunima Sinha. She is with us. We are very fortunate that she is with us. So you must welcome her. How many of you gone to mountain? Anybody? Mountain? Have you climbed mountain? How much height? 100 feet? 500 feet? 1000 feet? Huh? Who has done mountaineering? Anybody? Anybody who has gone to any mountain among the children? Yes. Please tell me how many. Have you gone to any mountain?
Yes, it's about 15,000 feet tall.
Oh, how many feet? 15, how much height?
15,000 feet.
50?
1,000. 15,000 feet? No.
15.
15,000 feet? Yes. He's already gone?
Huh?
But you are seen or you are climbed?
I just saw.
No, I want how many you have climbed. Have you gone to the top?
I only went halfway through.
Halfway?
Yeah.
Oh, that's wonderful. Anyway, we must give a hand to you. At least you go halfway. Now next time you go full way.
Okay?
Now, it is difficult to climb staircase. Supposing 1,000 staircase. Can you go 1,000 staircase?
Yes.
2,000 staircase?
Yes.
3,000?
Yes.
4,000?
Yes.
5,000?
Yes.
10,000?
No.
50,000?
Yes.
Now, how difficult it is to go 1,000 feet, you know? Very difficult. 2,000 feet? Very difficult. 3,000 feet, more difficult. Then, 10,000 feet, very difficult. Do you know any mountain, highest mountain in the whole world? Yes, one person, please tell.
Mount Everest.
Mount Everest, yeah. Very, very good. Mount Everest in Asia, near India, is the highest mountain of the world. Can you tell me the height of Mount Everest? Yes.
29,028.
Wow. 29, yes. Wow. Very nice. So, 29,029 feet, that is the topmost summit of Mount Everest of the whole world. There is no mountain higher than this. And Arunima Sinha has climbed that Mount Everest already. But all of you are having two legs? All of you two legs or one leg?
Two.
But she has only one leg. No? You show. Show. Then only they will understand. She has only one leg. Yes, you tell. This is artificial leg, plastic leg. This is plastic leg. With this leg she has gone to Mount Everest. World record! World record she has done! Now you believe me? She has got plastic leg? All of you got two leg? She has got only one leg. How got one leg? I will tell you the story. This is real story. On 11th April 2011, 4 years ago, she was traveling in a train. Have you seen a train?
Yes.
Yes, she was traveling in a train from Lucknow to Delhi. Delhi is the capital of India and Lucknow also is a big city. So 9 o'clock she boarded the train. At midnight, four robbers came with guns. Four robbers. And they started snatching all the things from the people. She was a national volleyball champion. She told, I will not give my chain, my necklace, I will not give, golden necklace. She said, my mom has given me, I will not give necklace. She started fighting alone. All the other passengers, they did not fight. They were afraid of these people. But she was so bold, she started fighting with the four people. Now these four people, they got very angry. Young girl, 23 years, and she has got the courage to fight with us. And after seeing her courage, others will also get courage. So they lifted her and threw her out of the running train. On the other side, there was another train that was coming. And that was also high speed. This was also high speed. So she collided with that. And by that time, she fell down. After 3 times colliding, then her left leg, this leg that you are seeing, got crushed under the train. And then whole night she was screaming, crying. Nobody came to her help. Next day morning some villagers came and then they took her to the nearby station. From there she was taken to Bareilly station. From then on the platform they thought she is already died. so like a dead body they kept for 2 hours, then the police came and then they thought, no, she's still alive. So they took her to hospital. Now the doctor saw already one leg is cut, second leg also bruised, head, you see her head, this is all head, there was lot of injury here, here, everywhere injury. Now this leg, that leg that was cut, started infection. So immediately it must be amputated. Now doctors were talking among themselves, this girl is going to die because the leg has developed infection. We do not have anesthesia to carry out the operation. She was still alive and she was, her eyes were closed, but she was listening. Then she cried out, no, I want to live. If you do not have anesthesia, you carry out operation without anesthesia. And the doctor said, you do not know, even with anesthesia people are crying, and without anesthesia you want us to carry out operation. She said, yes, I will bear all that pain, I am bold, I am courageous, you carry out the operation. And the doctors carried out operation without anesthesia for 2.5 hours and amputated her left leg. And then she bore all that pain. Afterwards she was shifted to another hospital in Lucknow, and after 4 days to big hospital in Delhi, All India Institute of Medical Sciences, and there she was treated for 4 months, and her left leg also again was amputated. 3 times it was amputated, again the surgery was done. Then there are left, this rod, this leg also contains rod, there are rods here, this leg contains rods. So likewise, then afterwards they people, in order to save the policemen and in order to save those robbers, they said, this girl is lying, this girl is lying, there were no robbers, this girl was trying to commit suicide and that is why she jumped and that is why her left leg did like this. She felt very bad. What? I was to commit suicide? This is all wrong. She told the media, this is all wrong. There were robbers. I can identify those robbers. They said, no, this girl is lying. Nobody believed her. Then on the hospital bed, she decided, okay, now you are not listening to me. I'll create a world record. I got only one leg. Doesn't matter. With this, left leg is gone. There is a plastic leg. Right leg, also broken with rods. With this broken right leg, I will conquer Mount Everest, create world record, then only all of you people will listen. And on 21st May 2013, 2 years back, she was on the top of Mount Everest, she conquered Mount Everest with one leg and created world record. She is the first female amputee of the whole world to climb Mount Everest, and also the first amputee of country India to conquer Mount Everest. Nobody has gone so far Mount Everest. All of them have gone with two legs. She is the only woman in the whole world who has gone with one leg to Mount Everest, conquered. And then before going there, she came to me. I am coming from Baroda. I am a monk of Ramakrishna Mission. This Ramakrishna Mission was started by Swami Vivekananda. And Swami Vivekananda stayed in the same bungalow where I am staying in Baroda. So the government of Gujarat gave this bungalow to us for converting to memorial in 2005. The Prime Minister of India, Narendra Modi, that time was the Chief Minister of Gujarat, he himself came and handed over the bungalow to us. Since then we have converted memorial, we have started memorial, and the room in which Swami Vivekananda stayed, we have converted into meditation room. She came to me at Baroda for giving a lecture. That was on 23rd January 2013, 2 years back. She told, by that time she had already climbed 20,000 feet. Now most difficult journey was there. She came to me before she conquered Mount Everest. Then she told, now most difficult part, the toughest game of my life I have to play. So I want your blessings. I said, I cannot give you blessings. I can give you best wishes, but you can receive the blessings, you can get the blessings from Swami Vivekananda himself. So I told her to go and meditate in the room in which Swami Vivekananda used to stay. She meditated there, she got a lot of energy, and then all her anxieties were removed. Then I gave her a photograph of Swami Vivekananda along with Sri Ramakrishna Sharada Devi, also gave her some books, particularly one small book I said, Thoughts of Power, very powerful book, small book. I said when you go to Mount Everest, you cannot carry much luggage. At least this small book you carry right up to the top, and small photograph, I said, you carry to the top. And she carried that photograph, that photograph became her energy capsule. And as I have told, she kept the photograph there on Mount Everest. Today also that photograph is there. She has put that photograph of Swami Vivekananda, Sharada Devi and Ramakrishna on the top of Mount Everest. So, she is not an ordinary girl. Outwardly she is looking ordinary, but she is extraordinary. She has done so many things. Now, I will... So, this is the photograph, that plastic photograph like this, that she has placed on the Mount Everest, because that photograph became her energy capsule. And they saved the life of this girl. How? When she was only 1000 feet away, that time her oxygen cylinder became empty. So the Sherpa said, you cannot go without oxygen on the top, minus 60 degrees Celsius temperature, 235 kilometer per hour, no oxygen there, so come back. She said, no, I have promised Swamiji that I will keep the photograph on the Mount Everest, and I am seeing the summit only 700 feet away. So, she took the calculated risk, okay, I will die. But before I die, I will put the Indian flag there on the topmost, and also I will keep the photograph there, fulfill my goal of life, and then I will die. So, she said, I will go low. Sherpa said, no, I will not go with you, because the people will say, because of you, this she died. She said, nothing doing. And she started walking up. Then the Sherpa followed. And what did she do? She reached on the top of Mount Everest on 21st May 2013 at 10:55 a.m. and created the world record. Then put the Indian flag and also the flag of Tata Foundation. They had sponsored the whole trip of 70 lakhs rupees. Then she told the Sherpa to take a video of 2 minutes. That video will be shown to you. I'll give that video will be given to Praveen Bhai. That video will be only 1 minute video. So she told the Sherpa, when I die, you send this video to India. I want to encourage and motivate all the youth that, and in that she gave the message, do not give up the goal of your life. Whatever you decide, you get it. Even at the cost of death. For example, today I am dying, but I have achieved the goal of my life. That was Mount Everest. That is the message she has given. After that, she worshipped this photograph. This photograph she worshipped there and kept it for good and started coming back. But there was no oxygen, so she fell down unconscious, almost unconscious. And she was just dying. Just dying. At that time, how God's grace can come? You must have heard the shloka from the Gita. Gita Dhyanam. Mukam karoti vachalam pangum langhayate girim yat rupa tamaham vande paramanand madhavam. By God's grace, a lame person can also climb mountain, and a dumb person can start speaking. She is a living example of this shloka. Now, at that time when she was dying, God thought, she worshipped me there on the Mount Everest, and she is always praying for me, so now I have to save her. So what trick God did, you know? God played a trick. How? A British person was going up with 2 oxygen cylinders for reaching Mount Everest. God told him, no, don't go. you go back. So, because the weather was very bad, so he started going back. Before going back, he was carrying two cylinders. So one, that was Shiva he was using, he threw. And another one, he kept on his head and started moving back. The Sherpa, her guide, saw it from a safe distance. He ran and brought that oxygen, half oxygen cylinder, and put it on her head. And had there been a delay of 1 minute, she would have died. But God wanted that she should come to this Gayatri Gyan Kandra Val Kendra and talk to you. So she is alive. God has made her alive so that she can talk to you. This is how she was saved. Then she came back. Then she told, God has saved me and put me to Mount Everest. I will take this photograph of Swami Vivekananda, Ramakrishna, Sarada Devi to other 7 summits of the world. In the whole world, there are 7 continents. How many continents?
7.
And there are 7 summits of the 7 continents, which are topmost. Now, the topmost mountain of Asia continent is Mount Everest. That she has done. Now she wants all the other 6 continents also. She will put the photograph there. So, 4 months back, she went to Africa, Kilimanjaro. She has conquered Kilimanjaro. 4 months back. And she has put the photograph there. Then, 3 months back, she went to Mount Everest, Europe, topmost in Russia. She has placed the photograph there. Mount Everest. Then, last month, she went to Australia, Kozhikode. Again, she has already placed the photograph there. Now, only 3 continents are left. Only 3 continents are left. She will be going in December and she will finish all that. So, that will be another world record. No amputee of the whole world, anywhere, has gone to all the 7 summits. She will be the first amputee, not only female amputee, she will be the first amputee with 1 lab to go to all the 7 mountains. That is the world record, she will create another. Second thing, she told, there are many Arunimas like me. Her name is Arunima Sinha. She is from Lucknow, Uttar Pradesh. She said, there are many Arunimas like me who also want to go ahead, but they are not getting opportunity. Fortunately, I got the opportunity, I got the help of Tatas, I got the help of Ramakrishna Mission, that is okay. But everybody is not getting. So, she has decided, I will start open an international sports academy for all those children who are differently abled people. They have some physical defect. All those children, she has already started this academy. And in India and also in many other countries, she is invited for giving motivational talk. You know, Mukam Koroti Vachalam, she never gave motivational talk, but by God's grace, now she is giving motivational talk in many education institutions, many, many companies, and whatever money she receives from these companies, she is putting all that money into the academy. She also wants to participate in Paralympic in Brazil in 2016. That also she is trying. So she is having lot of enthusiasm at this age, lot of dynamism, and she is working in so many ways. So we are very fortunate that this extraordinary girl is with you today, physically. Now, it is not video. You can see her video. There are so many videos. If you go to Google search, if you go to YouTube, many of her videos along with me, along with others, you will find in YouTube. In so many channels are taking her interview. Even today, tomorrow and day after, within 2-3 days, American channels are also going to have an interview. But you can see her many times in TV, you can see her many times in channels, you can see her in videos, but today you are seeing live, not only live, she is still right in front of you. That is your most fortunate. So now I will just give a story and hand over the mic to Arunima Sinha. She will talk to you in Hindi and English mixed. Afterwards, if necessary, I will translate to you. How many of you know Hindi? Please raise your hand. Hindi? Oh, very nice, very nice. Then better is that, I'll just give a small story and then she will talk in Hindi. And if so, those some people who cannot understand English, I'll make some small translation if necessary. Okay? Now, only one story. You want to listen to story?
Yes.
Who want to listen to story? Please raise your hand. Very nice. All of you want to listen to story. This story is a very nice story. This story was told by Swami Vivekananda in America. When he came to America in 1893, he told this story, and this story contains a very powerful message. Whenever you have got difficulty, whenever you have got problem in life, you remember this story. Okay? Should I tell the story?
Yes.
All of you are attentive?
Yes.
Are you listening?
Yes.
Sure?
Yes.
Very nice. Okay. There was a lioness. Have you seen the lioness?
Yes.
Who has seen the lioness? Please raise your hand. Lioness. Have you seen lioness? Where did you see? Yes. Where did you see? Oh, in the zoo. I am saying in a forest. I have seen a lioness in a forest. I have seen a lioness in my car. One boy saw it. One small boy said, "You know, I met a lion, huh? Then what happened? The lion looked at me, huh? And I looked at him, huh? You did not get fear?" "No." "Why?" "Because I was in the zoo. And the lion was under the cage. But I have seen a lion, so many lions, not in zoo, in the forest, not in the cage, outside, but I was in the cage. Otherwise that lion would have eaten me up. So I am here." Anyway, in Gujarat, I am coming from Gujarat, from Baroda. In Gujarat, there is a particular place called Gir Forest. So many lions are there, hundreds of lions. I went to Gir Forest in a special vehicle with a cage, and so I could go right inside. So many lions were playing. At that time, I saw the lion. Anyway, at least in the zoo, you have seen a lioness. Lion, you have seen a lioness? Okay. There was a lioness, you know how it is. Very, very fearful looking. Huh? So one lioness was going along the forest. Now, from one way, a flock of sheep was going. Have you seen sheep? Sheep?
No.
Where, in the zoo?
No.
Right, on the way?
In a farm.
Where?
In a farm.
Only in the TV?
Farm. No, in a real farm.
Really? In the farm, okay. In the farm, okay, fine. So you are seeing with your own eyes, okay? The sheep. You know, a flock of sheep was going along the path. Now this lioness wanted to cross the street. This lioness wanted to cross the
street.
So what did this lioness did, you know? She jumped over. She jumped over. When she jumped, there was a small cub in her womb. Small cub in her womb. So when she jumped, she was pregnant. She gave birth to a small cub, a small lion. And that lion, the small cub lion, fell into the group, flock of sheep. And the lioness jumped to the other side and she became unconscious. And then she started doing like this and then she died. Now, because why did she die? Because it gave birth to a small cub and then it jumped. So because of that terrific labor that she underwent, she died. Now this small cub started weeping because her mother had died. His mother had died. So the mother of the sheep, this flock of sheep, mother of the sheep, was very kind. She started taking care of the small lion. Now this small lion was going along with the sheep. What do they eat? Sheep, what do they eat?
Grass.
So this lion started eating grass. And It was this small lion was playing with the sheep, eating with the sheep. What did it eat? Grass. And you know the sheep, how do they bleed? Do you know? How do they bleed? Bam, bam. How do they bleed? Bam, bam. So this small lion also started telling bam, bam. Then afterwards, this small lion became big, big, big. After a long time, a big lion came. Big lion came to the forest. And he saw so many sheep are going bam, bam, bam. And by the end, it is a small lion. And that small lion also telling bam, bam. This big lion got very much surprised. This lion had never seen any lion telling like bam, bam. So it came near. What is the matter? It wanted to know what is the matter. So this big lion came near. When the big lion came near, this sheep became very much afraid. And they started running. Bam, 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 started running. This small lion also started running. Bam, bam, bam. Now that big lion caught up. Hey, where are you going? You are like lion like me. Why are you afraid? The small lion said, bah, bah. I am not lion. I am sheep. The big lion said, you fool. You are a lion. And you are saying I am sheep. You are not sheep. You are lion. The small lion said, bah, bah. I am not lion. I am sheep. They started weeping more and more. Now this big lion became very much annoyed. He is not listening to his wife. Caught hold of the small lion. Big lion caught hold of the small lion by the neck and dragged it near a well.
Oh my God.
There was a well nearby. Look! Look into the well, into the water. Look at your reflection. Look at my reflection. I am a lion. You are looking like me or you are looking like that sheep. Look! And the small lion looked in the water. Huh? My face is that of lion? Yes. My face resembles this lion. I am not sheep. Now you understand? You are lion. You are not sheep. You are lion. You are not sheep. Now give up this bam, bam, bam. Roar like me. Ah. Roar like me. And he started roaring like a lion. Now you are the king of the forest. And this lion became the king of the forest. Now, you tell me, this lion, small lion, was already lion or became new?
New.
It was already lion?
Yes.
Isn't it? It was already lion?
Yes.
Then why it was bleating? Bam, bam, bam. Why? Yes. Huh? Yeah. Because this small lion was in the company of sheep. So, you will become as per your company. So, if you stay with your bad friends, you will become bad. If you stay with good friends, you will become good. Jaisa sang, vaisa rang. You will become like your friends. If your friends are good, you will become good. If your friends are bad, you will become bad. If your friends are sheep, you will become like sheep. If your friends are lions, you will become like lion. Now, another thing is that, are you listening? Are you listening?
Yes!
Another thing is this small lion had forgotten that I am a lion. This small lion had forgotten that it was?
Lion.
Isn't it? It had forgotten. So, that is why it was bleeding. So now, the message of Swami Vivekananda comes. Swami Vivekananda says, all the human beings, all the human beings, irrespective of caste, creed, color, religion, nationality, have got Atma. What they have got?
Atma.
What they have got?
Atma.
What they have got?
Atma.
And this Atma has got infinite power. How much power?
Infinite power.
How much power?
Infinite power.
How much power?
Infinite.
This infinite power is in whom? in the Atma. And this Atma is whom? All human beings. In all human beings. But we have forgotten that Atma, and that is why what do we say? I am very weak, I am very, very weak, I cannot participate in the tournament, how can I participate, I am very weak, I cannot appear in the examination, I got lot of tension while giving examination, I will appear in the examination, I cannot walk like this, I am very weak, bam, bam, bam. We are doing bah, 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 like sheep. Why? Because we have forgotten that we are lion. So Swami Vivekananda's main message is that remember, you are a human being. How many are human beings? Please raise your hand. Not animals. I don't want animal to raise hand. Only human being. Please raise your hand. All are human beings? Okay. Now, very good. Now, everybody is a human being? Human being?
Yes.
Inside every human being there is Atma. Every human being there is
Atma.
And that Atma is how much power?
Infinite power.
This infinite power is in Atma. And that Atma is in every human being. So how many of you got Atma? Please raise your hand. Okay. How many of you got infinite power? Please raise your hand. You have got how much power? How many of you got infinite power and Atma? So many. All of you have got infinite power and yet you are telling, no, I am not power, I am powerless, I am weak, I cannot pass the examination, I am miserable, bah, bah, bah. Now no more bah, bah, bah. You are a lion or a sheep? Yes. Swami Vivekananda's main message is, come up, O lions! Come up, O lions! And shake off the delusion that you are sheep. Your soul is immortal. Spirit is free, blessed and eternal. Ye are not matter, you are not bodies. Matter is a servant, not ye the servant of matter. That is the main message of Swami Vivekananda. So that is the story, always remember. Now we will have 1 minute meditation, okay? Meditation, please, meditation. Meditation. Sit down for meditation, 1 minute meditation.
Oops.
Yes. Now you have to close your eyes. Close your eyes and meditate on whatever way you are meditating, you meditate. And while closing your eyes, thinking of the divine light which is inside your heart, repeat whatever I am saying. Inside me, there is infinite power.
There is infinite power
of the Atman.
Of the Atman.
I am not weak.
I am not weak.
I have got unlimited power.
I have got unlimited power.
I am not sheep.
I am not sheep.
I will not bleed.
I will not bleed.
I will always be strong.
I will always be strong.
Why?
Why?
Because
I have got
unlimited power.
Unlimited power.
I am lion or something. I am a lion.
I am a lion.
I am a lioness.
I am a lioness.
I am not sheep.
I am not sheep.
I am not sheep.
I am sheep.
I am not sheep.
I am not sheep.
I have got unlimited power.
I have got unlimited power.
I can do anything.
I can do
anything and
everything.
I can do.
I will do.
I will do. Nothing impossible for me.
Nothing impossible for me.
Because I have got unlimited power.
Because
I have got unlimited power.
I
am not sheep.
I am not sheep.
I am not sheep.
I am not sheep.
I am not sheep.
I am not sheep.
Oh. शांति ही
शांति
ही
शांति
ही
शांति
ही हरिओम. Now you can open your eyes.
That was so hard.
Meditation. So always remember, I am not she. I have what? Unlimited power. I can do anything and everything. And now here is a lioness of Lucknow. I told the story, lioness of Lucknow, and she was not cowed down by the difficulty. She said, "No, I can do anything and everything." And she said, "With only one leg, I'll conquer Mount Everest." She already conquered Mount Everest. She already conquered 3 more Everest. And her book, this is her autobiography, "Born Again on the Mountain." She already died almost on the railway track, but she said, "No, I am a lioness. I am not sheep. I am a lioness. I am not sheep." And so she had read the books of Swamiji. So she became so powerful. And then this book is "Born Again on the Mountain." This was released by the Prime Minister of India on 12 December 2014. Last year. This is the book. This is a beautiful book giving her own story, autobiography, from railway track to Mount Everest. The second story, another book will come after Mount Everest. Already she has conquered 3 more summits, and also she has started academy. She is every day she is in the aeroplane, every day, and she is going to so many places like you. There are many children also, and they are very big people, IIM, IIT, there are so many education institutions. She goes there for giving motivational talk with her own example. If I can do it with one leg, you can do it with? How many of you have got 2 legs? Please raise your hand. Oh, all of you have got 2 legs. She has got only 1 leg. With 1 leg she can do so much. With 2 legs she can do much more. That is why I brought her to you, to see that here is what 1 leg she can do so much. So we with 2 legs can do much more. So I will now, she with this lioness, will directly talk to you and give you motivational talk. Arunima Sinha, Padmashree. And she also received highest award from India, Padmashree. She is Padmashree, and also she has received another award. On 29th August this year, Tenzin Norgay Award, highest adventure award also she has got. And she has got so many awards. Now see, Arunima Sinha, Padmashree Arunima Sinha will be now talking to you. This lioness will be talking to you directly. Okay?
Want to ask something? Get up. You can get up and ask.
Good morning.
Line is standing.
Good morning.
Good morning.
In the morning you take breakfast?
Yes.
Why you speak slow? Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you. Good morning. My English is not very good. Can I speak in Hindi?
Sure.
Yeah.
Okay. आदरणीय स्वामी जी, और आज सर आपने मुझे इस 15 मिनट टाइम बाउंडेशन, मैं सब कुछ महाराज जी ने बता दिया. मैं कोई मोटिवेशनल स्पीकर हूँ, ना ही कोई मैं लेक्चरर हूँ. मैं तो एक माउंटेनियर और एक प्लेयर हूँ. और ये वो अलग चीज है कि लोग मुझे देखकर प्रेरित होते हैं, तो ये मेरे लिए बहुत बड़ी सौभाग्य की बात है. ये तो शायद नहीं समझ पाए, लेकिन आप लोग तो जरूर समझेंगे मेरी बातें, क्योंकि आप सब हिंदी समझेंगे आगे. और जैसा महाराज जी ने बताया, मुझे इन सब में से सबसे जो कुछ चीजें मैं आप लोगों को बोलूंगी, एक तो ये कि आज का यूथ ये सोचता है कि हम अपने लक्ष्य तक नहीं पहुंचे. लेकिन मुझे लगता है सबसे बड़ी प्रॉब्लम तो ये है कि हमारे पास कोई लक्ष्य ही नहीं होता है पहुंचने के लिए. सबसे पहले अपने जीवन में एक लक्ष्य निर्धारित करें और उस पर इतना फोकस करें कि ऊपर वाला भी देने पर मजबूर हो जाए. मैंने भी कुछ अलग से कुछ भी नहीं किया.
बहुत सारे लोग बोलते हैं गरिमा तू एक्स्ट्रा ऑर्डिनरी है, तू एक्स्ट्रा विल पावर है, लेकिन ऐसा नहीं लगता मुझे, कुछ भी ऐसा नहीं लगता, क्योंकि मेरा मानना है कि ऊपर वाला हर किसी के अंदर कुछ न कुछ क्वालिटी देता है, फर्क सिर्फ इतना होता है पहचानता कौन है। जिस दिन उस अपने अंदर की उस क्वालिटी को हम पहचान गए और इस भीड़ से एक कदम आगे उठाकर बढ़ा दिया, लोग हमें एक्स्ट्रा ऑर्डिनरी बना देते हैं, लोग कहना शुरू कर देते हैं कि हाँ यू आर द एक्स्ट्रा ऑर्डिनरी लोग। और इन सब को पाने के लिए सबसे ज्यादा जरूरी होता है कॉन्फिडेंस। कहते जो इनर पावर अंतरात्मा का विश्वास जिसको कहते हैं, वो हमें, मैं एक माउंटेनियर हूं, हमें सिखाया ही है ज्यादा, हमारी एक 9 mm की रोप होती है और उस 9 mm की रोप में 2000 किलो वेट उठाने की क्षमता होती है और एक छोटा सा कैरावेरन 50 ग्राम का होता है और उस 50 ग्राम के कैरावेरन में पूरा का पूरा ट्रक उठा सकता है। और अब एक नॉर्मल माउंटेनियर का वेट कितना होगा, ज्यादा से ज्यादा 50 से 60, शायद उससे अगर 80 होगा तो जाएगा नहीं, लेकिन मान लेते हैं कि 80 होगा, लेकिन जब 2000 किलो वेट की ताकत है उस रोप को उठा लेने की, तो ये सिखाया ही हमें जाता है कि उस अपनी ट्रेनिंग पे, अपने इक्विपमेंट्स पे और जिन्होंने, जो हमारे इंस्ट्रक्टर और जिन्होंने हमें ट्रेनिंग दी है, वो खुद पर और सबसे ज्यादा ऊपर वाले पे भरोसा रखिए, जीत हमेशा आपकी होती है। मैंने कुछ भी अलग से कुछ नहीं किया था। और दूसरा होता है जो अंतरात्मा का विश्वास, जैसे एग्जाम्पल के साथ में अगर मैं बोलूं तो बारिश में, जब भी बारिश होती है हम छाता लेते हैं और उस बारिश में उतर जाते हैं और हम चलने लगते हैं, जो भी अपना हमारा काम होता है हम आगे के लिए बढ़ जाते हैं, क्योंकि हमें ये भरोसा होता कि वो छाता हमें भीगने नहीं देगा। उसी तरीके से हमारा अंतरात्मा, हमारी अंतरात्मा की विश्वास होता है कि सफलता की पूरी गारंटी तो नहीं देगा, लेकिन उस सफलता में रास्ते में आने वाली जो बाधाएं हैं उसमें लड़ने की ताकत जरूर दे देता है। वो हमारा अंतरात्मा की विश्वास होता है, वो हमारा विश्वास होता है। निश्चित तौर पे आप सब एक अचीवर है इसलिए यहाँ पर है, लेकिन क्या सिर्फ इतना? एक पानी का जहाज सबसे ज्यादा सेफ कहाँ होता है? समुद्र के किनारे जब वो खड़ा होता है तो सबसे सेफ होता है, लेकिन क्या वो समुद्र का जहाज सिर्फ समुद्र के किनारे खड़ा रहने के लिए बना है? नहीं, उसका काम ही यही है कि वो जो भी गोल और टारगेट जो दिए गए उसको उठाए और अपने गोल तक पहुंचाए। अगर मैं अपना एग्जाम्पल लू कि मैं एवरेस्ट से आने के बाद मैं चुपचाप बैठ जाती तो शायद सिर्फ एवरेस्ट करके बस इतना, मैं नहीं बैठना चाहती थी, क्योंकि मुझे पता था कि मैं एक मनुष्य हूं और मुझे जो मुझे गोल दिया गया है वो गोल मुझे और भी पूरा करना है। तब मैंने 7 continents का ये फैसला लिया था कि मुझे 7 continents के हाईएस्ट पीक क्लाइंब करने हैं, जिसमें से 4 मैंने क्लाइंब किए, 3 बाकी है। दिसंबर में मैं साउथ अमेरिका अकांका गोवा पीक के लिए जा रही हूँ। एक एक करके मेरा यही एम है, एक एक करके 7 continents के 7 हाईएस्ट पीक मैं सबमिट करूँ और अपने देश का तिरंगा हर पीक पे लगाऊं। कुछ कुछ घटना मैं सिर्फ एवरेस्ट की बताऊंगी आप लोगों को, क्योंकि एक लाइव एग्जांपल है। 2 साल के अंदर 11 अप्रैल 2011 को मेरा एक्सीडेंट हुआ था और 21 मई 2013 पे मैं टॉप ऑफ द वर्ल्ड पे थी, सिर्फ 2 सालों के अंदर। नो डाउट मैं भी नास्तिक नहीं, मैं भगवान को मानती हूं, लेकिन यह भी सच है कि ऊपर वाला ही कहता है कि अगर 10 कदम चलने हैं पूरी ईमानदारी के साथ, एक कदम तू आगे बढ़ा दे, 9 मैं पार कर लूंगा। जब मैं रेलवे ट्रैक पे गिरी थी, मुझे जब बाहर फेंका गया था तो महिला आयोग ने रिपोर्ट मांगी थी रेलवे से, तो 49 ट्रेन अप डाउन हुई थी, 49 ट्रेन और रेलवे ट्रैक पे मैं 7 घंटे पड़ी थी, 7 घंटे रेलवे ट्रैक पे और 49 ट्रेन अप डाउन हो जाना, इतनी भयंकर भीषण एक्सीडेंट के बाद भी अगर ऊपर वाले ने मुझे बचाया था तो कुछ ना कुछ इतिहास रचने के लिए बचाया था। जरूरत सिर्फ इतनी होती है थोड़ा सा ट्विस्ट करके सोचने की। 2 तरीके के लोग होते हैं समाज में, एक वो होते हैं कि जो अपनी प्रॉब्लम को, जब भी कुछ और प्रॉब्लम तुम पे आती है तो डिप्रेशन में चले जाते हैं, एक दूसरे वो होते हैं उस प्रॉब्लम को ही अपनी अपॉर्चुनिटी बना लेते हैं। शायद मैं उन दूसरे तरीकों में से हूं, क्योंकि किसी का पैर कट जाना अच्छी बात नहीं होती है, और मैंने क्या किया, उस पैर को ही कट कटा अपॉर्चुनिटी बना दी, क्योंकि वर्ल्ड में कोई फीमेल में एवरेस्ट प्रोस्थेटिक लेग से गया ही होगा। दूसरा अगर मैं ये सोचती, जैसे महाराज जी ने भी बताया कि मैं नहीं कर सकती, मैं बहुत वही बे बे बे, अगर मैं वही करती तो आज अपने घर के कमरे में 20x20 के दाल रोटी की कभी मुझे कभी नहीं होती, लेकिन सिर्फ और सिर्फ मैं वो बैठ के अपने घर में दाल रोटी खाती और फ्री का मिलता मुझे आराम से। लेकिन मैं अपने सेल्फ रिस्पेक्ट, जिस कॉन्फिडेंस के साथ आज मैं आपसे बात कर रही हूँ, उस कॉन्फिडेंस से मैं आपके साथ कभी बात नहीं कर पाती। ये होता हमारा अपना सेल्फ रिस्पेक्ट। वो मुझे आज भी मैं CISF असिस्टेंट कमांडेंट सेंट्रल इंडस्ट्रियल सिक्योरिटी फोर्स में, DSP पद पर मैं एक्सटेंशन लेके मैं चाहूं तो आराम से मैं 200 लोगों के बटालियन आराम से लूं और लग्जरी ऑफिस, लग्जरी गाड़ी, सब कुछ लग्जरी। लेकिन क्या कभी मैं वो सब पाने के बाद भी मैं अपने सेल्फ रिस्पेक्ट को वापस ला पाती? शायद कभी नहीं। मुझे वो नहीं चाहिए था, मुझे ये चाहिए था, इसलिए मैंने इस चीज को किया। दूसरा होता कि हम बनना क्या चाहते हैं, जो हम बनना चाहते हैं वही हम बनते हैं। अगर मैं सिर्फ एक विकलांग रुणिमा बनकर जीना चाहती तो मैं विकलांग, आज लोग मेरा एग्जाम्पल देते हैं क्योंकि मैं यही चाहती थी। जो हम चाहते हैं वही होता है हमारे साथ। अगर हम ये सोच रहे कि नहीं 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 हो सकता, नहीं हो सकता, आपको सिम्टम्स दिखने शुरू हो जाएंगे कि क्यों नहीं हो सकता। अगर आप पूरी अंतर आत्मा से अपने गोल की तरफ, जो भी किसी भी क्षेत्र में आपका गोल है, अगर आपने तय कर लिया कि पाना है, तो आपको ये सिम्टम्स भी दिखने शुरू हो जाएंगे कि हाँ हमें मिलेगा। उसके सिम्टम्स भी दिखने शुरू हो जाएंगे। वो एवरेस्ट क्लाइंब करना कोई बहुत बड़ी बात नहीं है, जिसके पास भी जुनून, करेज और जिद और जुनून होगा वो करेगा। लेकिन बात करें आम आदमी की, जो रोज एक एवरेस्ट क्लाइंब करता है, क्योंकि उसके पास इतनी सारी जिम्मेदारियां होती हैं, इतनी सारी प्रॉब्लम्स होती हैं। आपके जीवन में जब प्रॉब्लम्स और जिम्मेदारियां चरम सीमा पे आ जाए, जब आपके मन से, आपके दिल से आह निकलना शुरू हो जाए, आप नहीं बर्दाश्त हो सकता, तब आप समझ लीजिए कि ऊपर वाला आपके लिए सुनहरा सवेरा लिख चुका है। बस एक काली रात की देर होती है, काली रात के लिए पार कर जाता है, एक सुनहरे सवेरे में लगा जाता है। कुछ भी अलग से करने की जरूरत कुछ भी नहीं होती है। मैंने सिर्फ इतना ही किया था और मेरे इस जर्नी में मेरा परिवार, परिवार का सपोर्ट बहुत, मेरा परिवार अगर एक शब्द में बोलूँ तो मेरा बैकबोन है। दूसरा स्वामी विवेकानंद जी मेरे आदर्श हैं। महाराज जी ने, जब फर्स्ट टाइम में महाराज जी से मिली थी मुझे, महाराज जी ने थॉट्स ऑफ पावर, एक शक्तिदायी विचार हिंदी में, उसका हिंदी वर्जन है, मुझे दिया था। और आज भी जब भी मैं फ्लाइट में फ्री जब भी होती तो मैं उसको पढ़ती हूँ। जैसे जब भी किसी, आई थिंक यहाँ सब ऑलमोस्ट यूथ ही है, जब भी हम किसी के घर जाते हैं या अपने घर जाते हैं, यहाँ से उधर अपने घर जाएंगे तो, या किसी दूसरे के घर जाते हैं तो सबसे पहले क्या खोजते हैं? निश्चित तौर पे वो प्लग ढूंढते हैं, प्लग कि अपना मोबाइल कैसे चार्ज करेंगे, सबसे पहले ढूंढते हैं। और क्योंकि जब मोबाइल नहीं चार्ज होगा तो हम अपना इंटरनेट कैसे करेंगे, और इंटरनेट कैसे, हम जुड़े दुनिया से जुड़े कैसे, हमेशा यही ढूंढता है यूथ। तो जैसे इलेक्ट्रिसिटी से, बिजली से हमारा मोबाइल चार्ज होता है, वैसे ही स्वामी विवेकानंद जी की कोट से माइंड हमारा चार्ज हो जाता है। तो जब भी हमारे माइंड को चार्ज करना हो तो और पूरी तरीके से चार्ज हो, मेरा माइंड हमेशा स्वामी विवेकानंद जी की कोट से चार्ज होता है, अलग से एनर्जी फील होती है। मैंने सिर्फ इतना ही किया है। और सिर्फ एक चार लाइन की पंक्ति में बोलूंगी, क्योंकि 15 मिनट सिर्फ है, हिंदी में बोल रही, पता नहीं सबको समझ में आ रहा नहीं आ रहा, लेकिन जो भी है मेरे दिल से आ रहा है। अभी तो इस बांझ की असली उड़ान बाकी है, अभी तो इस बांझ की असली उड़ान बाकी है, अभी तो इस परिंदे का इम्तिहान बाकी है, अभी अभी मैंने लांगा है समुद्रों को, अभी तो पूरा आसमान बाकी है।
Yes, please ask.
If we have infinite power, why can't scientists find vaccines for all diseases?
Very nice, very nice. Yes. You yes, you please ask the question. You give the mic to him. Give the mic.
Go there and ask.
Please ask the question.
Why can't scientists find cures for all diseases from vaccines?
Yeah. Very nice question. When we have got infinite power, why there are diseases and why some people are weak or they are not able to do certain things? Very good question. Now all of us have got how much power? Infinite power. That infinite power is in the Atma. That infinite power is in the Atma. Body has not got infinite power. It can go only a certain distance. Mind has not got infinite power. Atma has got infinite power. This Atma is inside every human being. Is inside every human being. But there is a covering. I will tell you. Can you see my face?
Yes.
All of you can see my face? We have got infinite power, but it is hidden. It is hidden by a covering. We have to remove the covering, then that infinite power will come to us. So infinite power is there, but it is hidden by covering. So how to remove covering? There are four methods by which you can remove covering and get infinite power. First, prayer. If you pray, this ignorance will be removed. If you pray, ignorance will be removed. Second method, meditation.
Second method, meditation.
Chidananda Rupa, Shivoham, Shivam. We meditated for 1 minute, no? I am not she. So you have to meditate after close eyes and see the divine light within. That is second. Third, read powerful books. Books of Swami Vivekananda, books, any other book that gives you power. Read good books and your thoughts will be transformed. That is third method, how to remove ignorance. Fourth method is unselfish service. Try to serve others. Try to serve your friends. Try to help your friends. Try to serve your parents. Try to serve the beggar. Try to serve the poor. Immediately you will get this remove will be ignorance. So this is a beautiful question. There is infinite power within all of us. All of us got that unlimited power in the Atman, but this Atman is covered by a layer of ignorance. That is why there was a very big poet in India. His name was Kabir. He used to say, Moko kahan tu dhunde bande, main to tere paas mein. Khojoge to abhi milunga pal bhar ki talash mein. I am there. Infinite power is there. Why are you searching outside? It is inside everyone. But we are not able to see. What is the reason? Kabir says, Ghungat ka pat khol re, tohe piya milenge. Kattu ko vachan mat bol re, tohe piya milenge. Remove the ignorance, the layer of ignorance, then you will get infinite power. Very good question. Thank you.
Swamiji is saying, answer your question very nicely, but I wanted to answer the other part of your question, that why you need the vaccination, why we have the diseases, okay? What's Atman is within us, and Lord Krishna also said that Atma has a chariot, and this body is a chariot. We have to keep the body fit, and that's the reason why body gets the diseases. and we want to prevent the diseases of the chariot. And that's why you need the vaccination. That's why you need antibiotics. So you're going to get sick, though you have an infinite power. And if you reach that level, maybe the disease will not come to you. But to reach that level, to reach that destination, you need this body, our chariot, to take our Atman to our final destination, the goal, to reach Lord. Within us is Atman and of Paramatman, to all of us are connected. And that's why we need the vaccination. You got your answer? Yeah.
That's a beautiful answer by Dr. Bhadraben Shah. This is she herself is a doctor. So that is why she can tell you better what to do, how to take care of the body. She herself is a doctor. Dr. Bhadraben Shah. And so the proper take care of your health, of your body. If you are doing yogasana, you must do take good food, nutritious food, and keep the body fit. Read good books, keep the mind fit, and then meditation, that will give you nourishment of the Atman, and the covering will be removed. If you want, you can see more of Arunima Sinha in a website. The name of the website is www.arunimasinha.com. If you go to Google search or YouTube, also you will get a lot of videos and a lot of lectures by her. And also, one copy of the book, some copies of the book will be here. Your parents can take and they can read out the books for you. And then also, we will be keeping one video so that you will be able to see what video she had taken on Mount Everest. So, we are very much thankful to Arunima Sinha for giving that message of a lioness, real lioness.
Available just now.
Oh.
Yeah, we have brought the books. You can buy now itself.
Oh.
It is brought out by Penguin. It is brought out by Penguin. It's available all over the world. But we have brought right from India so that we have got here. Of course, it is available all over the world.
If we have full infinite power, then why can we make vaccines that could fight all diseases?
The same question you could ask is
we have got infinite power in the Atman, but this body hasn't got infinite power. This body gets diseased, so you have to have medicine and you have to take proper care that the body does not get diseased. The disease is not in the Atman. Disease is the body. Body hasn't got infinite power. Infinite power is in the Atman. But by that power of Atman, you can make your body strong. You can make your mind strong. You can make your intellect strong. Ultimately, the power will come from within. But that is hidden. You have to bring that out. When that power will bring out, then only you will be able to say, yes, I have got infinite power. But before that, you have to remove that ignorance. How to remove the ignorance? You have to see the well. The small lion did not stop bleeding. But when it saw in the water and saw, yes, I am lion. So similarly, we have to see inside us our meditation. Then only we will get realization that we have got infinite power. But we have to remember to keep body fit so that we can do that meditation. Very good. Okay?
So, we are going to end the student session. Oh, yeah.
How do you know all of this?
What a beautiful question. I never faced such type of difficult problem. She asked me, how do you know all this? So, the same process, I try to meditate, I try to pray, I try to do unselfish service, and also I try to read the books of Swami Vivekananda and try to put them into practice right from my childhood. Right from my childhood, I am doing that. That is why I can know so many things. Okay? So you also read, you also meditate, you will also become like me. Okay?
स्टोरी जो आपने बताई, शुक्रिया, हम सब बच्चों के साथ आपने शेयर करी. बट इफ यू कैन एक्सपेंड ऑन वन थिंग, आपने बोला कि मैं पहला कदम लूंगी, बाकी नौ वो देगा कदम. मैनी ऑफ अस स्पेशली द यूथ, द टफेस्ट थिंग इज टेकिंग दैट फर्स्ट स्टेप. Can you help our children and how we can start, or how the parents can help them take that first step? Because I think as a parent and my kids, it's very challenging. Thank you.
Good question. Arunima had told, if you go one step towards God, what will come? Nine step. But how to take the first step? That is the thing. How to take the first step? That is difficult. Now that is exactly why I brought this lioness here. So you can see, with one leg, she can conquer Mount Everest by the grace of God. So grace of God can make impossible possible. Whatever is impossible for me, but there is no impossible for God. And that God is present here inside our heart. So by the grace of the God, infinite can be done, impossible work can be done. We have to put that faith. That is why Swami Vivekananda said, we want two types of faith. Two types of faith. Faith, faith, faith. Faith in ourselves and faith in God. If we have these two types of faith, that is the secret of greatness, that is the secret of success, and that is the secret of everything. So what we have to do? Two types of faith. Faith in ourselves. Yes, I can do it. Second is faith in God. Because whatever is impossible for me, the thing impossible for me. I may be able to go to the top, but I may not be able to get oxygen cylinder on Mount Everest. But God can give you God can give you oxygen cylinder on the top of Mount Everest, and He can tell that Britisher, throw this oxygen cylinder, and He can make impossible possible. But before that, we have to take the first step. When the Sherpa told, you cannot go without oxygen, she took a, okay, if I can't take oxygen, I will die, but I will fulfill my dream, my goal. So she took that step, of one step, so God thought, now I must take nine steps, and she came forward and gave oxygen cylinder. So these two types of faith are there, faith in yourself, faith in God. Then impossible becomes possible. More and more difficult questions. Now, God is made up of three letters. Can you tell me three letters? G, O, D.
Generator, operator, destroyer,
symbol. G means generator. G means generator. O means organizer. O means. And D means destroyer. D means destroyer. Now, first of all, you have to generate. The whole world has been generated by God. That is why generator. Then, the whole world is maintained by God. Such a beautiful organization. He knows what time sunrise should be there, what time sunset should be there, everything. So many stars, so many galaxies, all He is organizing. So, organizer. And when the things become very bad, when the thing becomes old, what do? You destroy. Old batteries, you destroy. Isn't it? Old batteries, you destroy. So, why destroy? Because if you don't destroy the old building, new building will not come. If you want a new building, old building should be destroyed. So, God does three actions. Generator, organizer, and destroyer. He also destroys ignorance within us. Whatever ignorance, He will destroy. He has got that power. We cannot destroy our ignorance, but He destroys our ignorance. He destroys our ill feelings. He destroys lust, anger, feeling of jealousy. All these He can destroy. He has got that power. So God is the great power, infinite power, doing these three things. G, O, D. And that is why He is God. And where is He present? He is present everywhere. He is present everywhere. How He is present? You are saying present. I am not able to see it. I am not able to see. Okay, bring a computer. Start computer. Start work. Computer not working. So what you have to do? Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi is everywhere. But you do start Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi is not coming. What you have to do? You have to give the password. If you give the password, Wi-Fi will come and you are connected with the whole world. Similarly, in order to get God, you have to give password. That password is your faith. If you have got faith, password, then you will be able to see God. So password is necessary, then Wi-Fi will come. So password is faith in God, then you will be able to see God. So start using your password, okay?
Thank you for your
wow. She is telling, thank you for your presence. Come here.